In today's video, we're out on location again at the University of Nottingham because they have a butterfly that is apparently unphotographable. I'll explain more in just a sec. Hi guys, I'm Ben from Adaptalux and welcome back to another macro photography tutorial where today we're here at the School of Life Sciences, Nottingham University, because they have a huge entomological collection of thousands of really interesting specimens from butterflies to fossils and all sorts of weird and wonderful things in jars as well. There's literally too much to photograph in one session, but I want to focus in today on some butterflies and one specific butterfly that's pretty tricky to photograph. So I've just grabbed Tom from the university to tell us a little bit about this special butterfly. Tom, what's your role here at the university?
Well, I'm part of the team that teaches the MSc in biological photography and imaging. And I'm also here as a general lecturer, and I do mainly stuff under the microscope and invertebrate zoology. So that's why we've got so many specimens here, so we can illustrate what we're teaching the students with real examples of what we have hanging around.
So what is special about this butterfly that we're shooting today, the lesser purple emperor?
So the purple emperor is a really interesting butterfly. It is rare in Britain. It used to be more common. They're a woodland butterfly and they live high in the canopy. And when they come down to the ground, they're normally in search of salt. So you might see them in the early morning coming down and just licking stuff off the path or off roads because of all the gritting that goes on. So they need some salt. What's really interesting about them, which is different from a lot of the other insects, is that their color is very directional. So I've got here a emperor butterfly, and you can see it's incredibly bright. Now, this color is not made from pigment, but from very, very fine structures on the scales of the wings that interact with light to give this color. So it's really is incredible, which means that when they die and the pigment isn't being maintained, an animal like a dragonfly or a damselfly will lose its color. But these insects don't, because it's a structural color.
Okay, so what would make this lesser purple emperor difficult to photograph? Because you mentioned directional color.
Yes. I don't really understand what the precise mechanism is, but it must be something to do with the angle of the scales on its wings, which means that every time you look at and you tilt your head, the sheen, the iridescence is different, which means you can photograph it, but you will never photograph the lived experience of it. So there are beautiful photographs of it with all the sheen visible or with no sheen visible. But when you're actually looking at it live and you tilt your head or you move slightly, the pattern changes. And that's the shimmering effect, which some have called it the impossible to photograph insect.
Well, that's really interesting. Thank you for giving us a little bit of background on the butterfly today. And I am going to take that challenge to try and photograph or at least demonstrate to you guys the color that is present on the wings of this butterfly, because it is absolutely beautiful. I've grabbed a purple emperor from the collection and just placed it down on a white sheet of paper with some sticky pads, just raising the butterfly up off the ground so that we can get a little bit of light in here and make it easier to remove the background. Now you can see that this butterfly is actually much smaller than the blue emperor, but it's still got that same colored sheen. It's really hard to demonstrate this, but as Tom was saying, moving your head around, you can start to see a little blue sheen just on the wings. Now I want to photograph this and try and demonstrate it using lighting. I'm going to get a top-down shot first of all. So I've placed my camera up on the table up here, and I'm going to be adding some lighting in from a couple of different directions to try and get that iridescence to show through on the wings. So I think it goes without saying that we're going to need some highly controlled light to pull this off. We need to be able to place the light exactly in the correct spot to shine off the iridescence on the wings of this butterfly. Being able to move the light around and experiment is going to be critical for showing off that blue sheen. And obviously the way that we're going to be doing that is using the Adaptalux Studio. So I've got the control pod here on a little mini tripod, and I've got a few different white lighting arms, including lighting arm S's, which are the brighter version of our regular white lighting arms. I'm going to set all of this up just behind my butterfly with a couple of lighting arms pointing down onto the wings, and maybe a couple more just to light the background and make it a nice pure white. So as you can see here, well, you can't actually see because it's completely blown out the butterfly on this camera, but we do have two white lighting arm S's pointed down at the butterfly and a third regular white lighting arm just filling in a few of these shadows down at the bottom. I might add another lighting arm down here just to eliminate those shadows altogether, but otherwise we can just take that out using Photoshop. Now, what you can't see via this camera is that we're getting that blue sheen. It's not from every single angle. As you move around, the blue comes and goes, but the placement of these arms is just getting a little bit of blue on the main camera up here. What I've actually had to do is angle the lighting arms so that the light beams cross over one another. So this lighting arm is actually lighting only this left-hand wing, and this lighting arm is lighting the right-hand wing. Mixing the light together from two different directions on the same wing actually cancels out that iridescence and makes it look a little bit less obvious and a little bit less colorful. Another factor to consider with your lighting is diffusion. Usually with macro photography, diffusion is desirable and it will make your images look a little bit more pleasing to the eye with less harsh shadows. However, I did try shooting this blue color with diffusion initially. I popped a diffuser onto our lighting arms. They just magnetize on and off. But I found that the multi-directional light that you get from a diffuser, it's obviously coming from a much larger surface area and coming from a couple of different directions. I think that actually diminished the blue color. So direct harsh light is actually working in our favor when trying to bring out the blue color on the wings of the butterfly. So when you're photographing something on a white background like this, shadows are really important to be aware of. They're not critical if you cast some shadows down onto the white paper like I am doing here, but it's really handy to try and outline your subject with as much white or as close to white as you can get. That makes it much easier to cut it out later in Photoshop using most methods, including Photoshop's own AI selection tools. It's really easy to just identify the subject out from the background if there's a high contrast between the subject and that white. So it's not super critical to get a perfectly white background every single time, especially when you've got something like this, which is so heavily dependent on the light falling on the subject. The background is much less of a priority than getting that blue to shine through. So I'm placing my lights primarily to light the subject in the way that it needs to be lit, and the background is a little bit of an afterthought. So I think I've got a pretty good shot of this butterfly from the top down. It really is millimeter specific in the placement of your lights as to whether that blue shows up from the specific angle that your camera is pointed at. You can be looking from the side and see all of that blue with your own two eyes, but your camera will be at a slightly different angle and it might not be seeing the same thing. As Tom said earlier, it really is hard to represent what this looks like in real life. Moving the camera around does a little bit of the same effect, but seeing that blue change as you move around really has to be done in person. I'm going to try and get a little bit closer to this butterfly now and see if we can't see a little bit more detail and color in the wings from much closer up. So is the lesser purple emperor unphotographable? Well, I'll leave it for you to decide, because seeing that shine up close and in person is certainly very different to just seeing images of it. However, we have managed to be able to place our light in the correct spot to be able to show that blue light in, well, most of its glory. So I'd probably leave it as difficult to photograph butterfly, but certainly very, very interesting. I'd like to know from you guys whether or not you'd like to see us come back here to the University of Nottingham and take a look at some of the other subjects and specimens that they have here. All of them are going to require some really interesting and potentially complex lighting scenarios and photography techniques to really show off in their full glory, and there's plenty to take a look at. So let me know down in the comments if you'd like to see more videos just like this one. But for now, that is all that I've got time for. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.